Hello, welcome once again. In this video series, we will see what Niagara is and how to use the Niagara system for creating excellent VFX. In the earlier videos in this series, we have seen the making of simple sprite emitters in CPU and in GPU. In this video, we will see static meshes in some balloons flying. Please like this video if you find it helpful and informative, and subscribe to our channel for newer updates and game development tutorials. So let's start. Spawning a static mesh instead of a camera-facing sprite can increase the realism of the effects you are creating. In this video, we will show how to set up a Niagara emitter to spawn static meshes instead of sprites. Let's see what are the prerequisites. In this video, we will use the shape_sphere static mesh, which is found with the starter content. If you have not done so already, make sure that the static mesh or the starter content has been added to your project. First, start with creating a material for mesh. The effect in this video is meant to look like a cloud of balloons being released. To enhance this effect, you will make a simple material that makes the mesh look like a rubber balloon. Right-click in the content browser and under Create Basic Asset select Material. Name the new material Alloon. Double-click it to open in the material editor. In the palette panel, type particle in the search bar. Select particle color and drag it into the graph to add a particle color node. Drag off the RGB output and connect the wire to the base color input on the material node. While holding down the one key, click in the graph. This creates a constant node. Copy and paste it twice, for a total of 3 constant nodes. Connect the output on one constant node to the metallic input on the material node. You can set the value of a selected constant in the details panel under material expression constant. This material is not metallic, so leave the metallic constant's value at 0. Connect the output on the second constant node to the specular input on the material node. With the specular constant node selected, set the specular value in the details panel to 0.7. This will give the material a slightly reflective surface. Connect the output on the third constant node to the roughness input on the material node. With the roughness constant node selected, set the roughness value in the details panel to 0.2. This will create a mostly smooth surface. Your final result for the material should look like this. Now let's create the Niagara system and emitter. Niagara emitters and systems are independent. The current recommended workflow is to create a system from existing emitters or emitter templates. First, create a Niagara system by right-clicking in the content browser and selecting FX and then Niagara system. The Niagara emitter wizard displays. Select new system from selected emitters. Then click next. Under templates, select fountain. Click the plus sign icon to add the emitter to the list of emitters to add to the system. Then click finish. Name the new system mesh system. Double-click to open it in the Niagara editor. The emitter instance in your new system has the default name of fountain, but you can rename it. Click the name of the emitter instance in the system overview and the field will become editable. Name the emitter ash. Now change the renderer. The render group is last in the stack, but you need to change some things so that the effect displays the way it is supposed to. In this case, the template contains a sprite renderer, and this effect needs a mesh renderer. In the system overview, click render to open it in the selection panel. To make a mesh particle effect, you need a mesh renderer module, but the template has a sprite renderer module. Click the trash can icon to delete the sprite renderer. Click the plus sign icon for render and select mesh renderer. Click the drop-down for particle mesh and select shape_sphere. The sphere shape used in this effect has a default material applied to it. By enabling override materials, you can use the custom material you created instead. Click to enable override materials, then click the plus sign icon to add an element to the array. Click the drop-down for explicit mat and select alloon. Edit emitter update group settings. First, you will edit the modules in the emitter update group. These are behaviors that apply to the emitter and that update each frame. In the system overview, click the emitter update group to open it in the selection panel. Expand the emitter state module. Because you used the fountain template, the life cycle mode is set to self. Click the drop down and set the life cycle mode to system. This enables your system to calculate the life cycle settings, which usually optimizes performance. The spawn rate module creates a continuous stream of particles while the emitter is active. This module is already present in the fountain template. Set the spawn rate to 100. Now edit particle spawn group settings. Next, you will edit the modules in the particle spawn group. These are behaviors that apply to particles when they first spawn. In the system overview, click the particle spawn group to open it in the selection panel. Expand the initialize particle module. This module collects several related parameters together in one module, minimizing clutter in your stack. Under point attributes, locate the lifetime parameter. This parameter determines how long particles will display before they disappear. For this effect, you will use a dynamic input called random range float to randomize how long the particles display. Random range float is already applied to the lifetime parameter in the fountain template. Set the minimum and maximum values as minimum 2 and maximum is 4. Locate the color parameter. Change the RGB values to the following. The material you made in the Create a Material section has no color designated inside it. To make the mesh particle look like a balloon, you have to set a color. There are modules that can change the color in various ways in the Particle Update group, but for this effect a solid color is simpler and works fine. Do the setting as red 0, green 0, blue 1. Under Sprite Attributes, set Sprite Size Mode, Sprite Rotation Mode, and Sprite UV Mode to unset. Since you are using a mesh, these attributes are not needed for this effect. The original sphere mesh is pretty large, so it looks better for our effect if we make it significantly smaller. Under Mesh Attributes, set Mesh Scale to Non-Uniform. Set the X, Y and Z values to 0.2. The Add Velocity module will give the particles movement as soon as they spawn. Add the Add Velocity module to the Particle Spawn section by clicking the plus sign icon and selecting Velocity and then Add Velocity. Because this effect is meant to look like balloons being released, some randomness to the speed of the particles is needed. Click the downward arrow next to the velocity value fields and select dynamic inputs and then random range vector. This spreads out the particles and gives them a small amount of movement on the X, Y, and Z axes. Now set the velocity minimum and maximum values. This gives the effect a small amount of movement on the X and Y axis, and a larger amount of movement on the Z axis. Minimum is X, 15, Y, 25, Z, 50. And maximum is X, 30, Y, 30, Z, 100. The sphere location module controls the shape of the location where sprites spawn. You can have the sprite spawn in a sphere shape, and you can set the size of the sphere shape by indicating a radius. Set the sphere radius to 200. This spreads the particles out more, as balloons would do when released. Drag your mesh system into your level. When you make a particle effect, it is always a good idea to drag your system into a level. This gives you a chance to see every change and edit in context. Any changes you make to the system automatically propagate to the instance of the system in your level. Now you will edit the modules in the Particle Update group. These behaviors apply to an emitter's particles and update each frame. In the system overview, click the Particle Update group to open it in the selection panel. Typically, you would use the Gravity Force module to simulate how gravity affects objects. You can also use it more generally to add acceleration to your particles. Set the Gravity Force X, Y and Z values. X as 10, Y as 10, and Z as 40. The Drag module applies drag to the particles, which slows them down. Set the drag to 1.0. The Scale Color module is part of the fountain template, but this effect does not require it. Click the trash can icon to remove the Scale Color module. Congratulations! You've made a mesh particle effect in Niagara. This effect is meant to simulate a big cloud of balloons being released, but it uses a very simple mesh and material. You can get a more realistic look by replacing the simple mesh and material with more detailed meshes and materials. However, you can still bring some colorful changes into it by adding some colors. Go to Initialize Particles and then to Color Mode. Then click the drop-down on color and say, Aked Random Range Linear Color. Repeat the same for minimum and then maximum, and then select the different colors. Your module should look like this. And you will have multiple colors balance. Hope this video will help you to initiate your journey into the creative world of Niagara. Thanks a lot, see you in the next video.